Hey, Danny.
Take a look at this. It's the infrared video footage from outside the dressing room around our Vic's TOD. Fasten your seatbelt. Here it comes.
Is the camera malfunctioning?
That or Fifth Avenue's haunted.
Right. Okay, well, there's our Vic.
Yeah, and he follows the blur into the dressing room, goes in, bang, and the gun goes off.
Oh, freeze that right there. Any way you can clean the image up a little more?
Might be able to go tighter, but that's as good as it gets.
So how do we catch a killer when our only suspect is a ghost?
Turns out our suspect is not as spooky as she wants us to believe. All right, come on. If this was a real ectoplasm, what's she doing shopping? Unless it was like the spirit of Imelda Marcus, but no, I don't even think she's dead. I mean...
Adam? Yeah. How'd she do it?
Oh, yeah, okay. Check this out, right? The retroreflective material on this vest is mirroring incident illumination back to the camera signal.
Mm. All right, so whatever she wore into the store, it interrupted the infrared signal on the security camera.
Creating the void and making her disappear. Sid recovered the bullet from the security guard. It's a .38 caliber. It was moderately deformed. I ran it through IBIS, no hits. I'm also looking into sources for retroreflective clothing.
Angel pulled up some complaint forms. Dolce & Gabbana, Gucci, Ferragamo, all hit the same day, all with the same MO. Burnt security tags left in the woman's dressing room. And at Gucci, the thief left behind the clothes that she was wearing when she came into the store, and they weren't retroreflective.
Oh, that means she started at Gucci, ended up at Maddox.
Right, well, average shoplifter can hit one, maybe two stores in one day.
There's nothing average about this girl. She's a professional, and she hasn't left us much to work with.
Except the security tags. We can rebuild those barcodes. We may be able to inventory the stolen goods. Best way to find a thief is to find out what they're stealing.
Based on the width of the burn and the pinpoint detail and the fuel, I've narrowed down what our suspect's using to burn the tags off.
A blowtorch?
Yeah, burns are small, precise, just like what you get with compact torches used in dental labs. Okay, so we have a dental mirror and a dental torch.
So we're looking for a klepto dentist who has an itchy trigger finger.
Who also has very expensive taste, okay? I sent copies of the barcodes to all the stores that were hit. Every item is four figures and up, along with a purse worth $25,000.
Boys love their cars, girls love their handbags.
I don't get over to Fifth Avenue much, okay, unless Simmons is bumper to bumper. But a purse this rich is not gonna be displayed on the counter, waiting to be snatched.
That's right, you're gonna have to ask the clerk to show it to you.
Means we have witnesses.